Okay, my friends of Qatari Labs, it has already run for 6 seconds. So actually we can see the results by typing Paraform, and then we can launch the Paraform, and then you can do apply and so. But for our case, it is not so. We won't do this. We are going to use a ParaView state. Okay, what is a ParaView state? It's a pre-configured ParaView project. Okay, that it will help us to see the results in some predefined views. Okay, so let's use ParaView I'm going to use the ParaView that comes with OpenFOAM for Windows. Okay, and then I use load state, and then I go to my documents. Okay, you will receive as well this state on the description of the video. And this is the virkaroll too. Okay, and the state actually do not find any, because we have to, I mean, the state is only the predefined view, but we have to set up the data that will come with this view. So we go to here. We go to we go to here to this water.foam. Okay, and this. Okay, and then we do apply. Okay, and this is much better because it has already has the views, has the contour, and this is the grid, and this is a cross section, so on. So this is very useful to do the representations. And then, okay, I hope that you have found the steps to do that. Okay, so we can run this, and then you can see how this slope is, how is the failure process of this slope, because actually the failure has, I mean, we have set up that the failure is only this part, okay? So it's actually not here and neither here, okay? So, and something that is very interesting for you is to see how the viscosity and the virkaroll is. Okay, the initial velocity is only on this, on the surface part of the slope, but once there is the erosion, so it has already been eroded, there is a decrease on the velocity, and the decrease in the velocity means the increase on the viscosity, and this will prevent the whole, I mean, on the failure zone of the slope, and not in the whole, on the whole hill, no? Okay, so I hope that you find this tutorial interesting, and then you can do your own stuff for your own tailor. You can increase the accuracy of these simulations by actually doing some research on actual failures, and then if you have the topography of the failure, like, you can assess better your virkaroll or maybe your Hurley-Buckley parameters. Okay, so thank you for following us, thank you for following Qatari Labs. We hope that you find this tutorial useful, and we hope that to see you in coming tutorials. So you like this video, why don't you subscribe to this YouTube channel, and hope to see you in coming, well, and have a great day. Bye bye.